Thank you. So, friends, there is some beautiful quote which says, those who have nothing to lose, they are born to win. To win, you only need tremendous confidence in yourself. Rest, everything is available in this world. Manpower, machinery, tools, money, everything is available. You should have great desire. You should have direction. You should have dedication. And you should have devotion. See, I am born in a very poor family. I lost my father when I was 2 years old. In that age, you don't know what is life, what is dead, what is father, whether there is support, no support. Somehow, I did my primary education in a small town. When I was doing my primary education, maybe up to 6th or 7th standard, I was very active. Normally people or the parents, they want a silent guy that he doesn't make any trouble. But I was very active. I used to do something. I'll not sit quiet in the corner. I keep on doing something. And probably that built some creativity in me. Now this creativity tempted me to go for engineering subjects when I went to primary education, secondary education. Primary education went very well. Secondary education, there was some problem about funds and all. But in those days, there was a lot of government support. So through the government support, I could complete my education. From 8th standard to 11th, I opted for engineering subjects because I had that attitude to do something. There were elements of electrical mechanical engineering, machine drawing, and workshop technology. 4 years, if you study these subjects, that brings a good creativity, some desire to do something, and you know some basic fundamentals about engineering. Now, after my 11th standard, I was thinking of going to engineering. So I approached my guardians that I want to go to engineering college, I want to become an engineer. At that instant, it was a surprise for me that I was told that who will spend for you? There was nobody to spend for my further education. So no direction, no what to do. So I got different advices from different people. Okay, go to some small courses, go to some typing, this, that. But then somebody suggested me to go to ITI. It's a 1.5 years course, and you learn something about engineering, little bit more. So I did my ITI, and this I did in my sister's place, where I had some place to stay. And after my completion of my ITI, I came back to my town. Now, where to get job? Some of my relatives was staying in Mumbai. He had some approach in some multinational. So he thought that, okay, I'm a bright student, I'm a poor student, so he should support me. So he called me to Mumbai and he arranged my employment in one multinational company. This was when I was maybe 17 years old. I started my job, or maybe 19 years old. I started my job, my salary was 4 rupees a day. whatever you get, you hardly happen to maintain yourself. So I was going for a training period for 6 months. After my 6 months training, I got a probation period. My continuous hard work in this throughout 6 months, and I put my knowledge. See, knowledge is the only tool which helps you throughout your life, and you should thrive for getting knowledge from wherever possible. We could not buy books, so I used to go to library, but learn. If you, whatever you have learned, you go for next step, like keep on learning, acquire knowledge. Knowledge will give you recognition. So my knowledge, my dedication, my hard work, after 6 months, I was in a probation. And after 6 months probation, I was transferred to another plant where they started manufacturing electric motors. In my, when I was confirmed, when I was doing this, I was working in an electric motor manufacturing unit. My only aim was to wholeheartedly work throughout my time and beyond my normal work. So unless you increase your capacity, you enter into more fields, other fields, you will not have complete knowledge about the product. So I used to keep on working. After I used to finish my work within a short time, ask for more work. Sometimes what happened, my boss, when I used to approach him, he said, Mr. Dole, please don't come to me. I don't have more work for you. So you should come to that stage that you should build your capacity to do more work, and you should build your capacity to take over the entire operations, not only in one corner. Because of this attitude, my knowledge, my hard work and all, almost every year, after one year, I used to get promotion. I joined in a quality control department, which opens the wide field for you to know everything about the engineering, product and all. Now, somewhere after getting as the inspector, then I became group leader, then junior engineer, then senior engineer. The time came now for the next promotion. And there I was told that, Mr. Dole, you cannot get promoted. The reason was, I was not graduate. See, knowledge is one, and graduation is certificate is one. You all go to college, many people, they have the focus on getting certificate. But certificate is just a recognition that you have gone through the college and you have spent 4 years or so. You focus on getting the knowledge in that 4 years' time. It is a very precious time of your life. Knowledge will shine, make you shine everywhere. See, 50% of the entrepreneurs in India, they are dropouts. But it is their knowledge which has put them on the line. So when I was told now you cannot get promotion, I thought of using my skill, my labor, my interest, my merits in the open market. So somewhere in 76, I thought of doing something my own, but there was no money, no support, no guidance. But whatever knowledge was there, I was confident that I can go to the market and use my knowledge and get success. Now, how to do this? Because I was married with one kid. How to do this? Keeping my family safe. So 2 years consecutively, I was working two shifts. 16 to 18 hours a day. One shift concentrating on building my small workshop. One shift in multinational for my livelihood. When I was working from 8:30 morning up to 11:30, I started building my small workshop. Some of my friend, he was also having some small workshop. So he said, if you have no excuse and you want to do business, I'll support you. So he offered me a small corner in his tin shed, 3 feet by 3 feet, 9 square feet, I started my activities. One person, 9 square feet, no tools, no money. I used to go to different industries, get some job, small job. When you are small, you are not equipped, go to the small customer. I used to go to the small customer, walking, sometime by cycle, sometime by bus, get some small job, bring it myself, do it myself. After 1 month, I got one raw hand, I trained him. Within first 6 months, in that 9 square feet, I earned some 5,000 rupees. This was in 1976-77. With that 5,000, now it is always the urge to grow. With this 5,000, I have taken one shed on deposit and rental. From my salary, I used to pay rent. And I started getting guys over there, started training them. Slowly, slowly, what helps you to success is your merits, your honesty, your dedication. All that, when it started going in the market, that okay, there is somebody who knows a little better. See, you should be known by your merits, your knowledge. You know, a rose, flower, it doesn't advertise anywhere. You see, you smell that fragrance, and then you start searching where this fragrance is coming from. So should happen that when this talent, we have to go and search. So that you build, then the market is yours. So after few years, we started getting recognition. 2 years consecutive work for 2 shift helped me to collect some finance. So I thought this is the right time. Now I can give up my job. At least next 2 years, I can live on whatever is collected. And within this 2 years, next 2 years, I will definitely get something more. So it will continue. So I left my lucrative job in 1978. As you know, this is a normal tendency in us that you will start criticizing the guy. You are a fool. You are giving up such a valuable job, such a multinational company. What you are going to do? You don't have anything. No finance, no support, no place. But that your confidence. I had tremendous confidence that yes, I am going to get work, I am going to get recognized. Honestly, consistently, you keep on working. So after my leaving my job, I started moving in a little bigger shed. So what I did, I collected best of the hands, I collected best of the brains, that is your asset. Every time what I earn, I plow back to update my infrastructure. Unless you have infrastructure, you will not get recognition, you will not go further. So I used to, instead of using that money for my enjoyment, I used to plow it back. Slowly, slowly, one small workshop, then one small factory, then bigger than that, bigger than that. Today, guys, I have 300 people working with me. We are a 100 crore company. We are recognized throughout India. We are recognized in the world. We are in the field of electric motors and generators. I started repairing small motors. Today, we have touched, we can handle 15,000 horsepower. We have 4 factories, number of engineers, and we are manufacturing and we are servicing. Now we are recognized by all the multinationals from the world. So friends, there is sky is the limit. You should become an entrepreneur like a people tree. You know what is people tree? It will break through the stone wall and stand erect. In rains, in winds, in sun, and that will only grow. Don't bow down. Don't get deprived of failures. What is failure? Failure is only delayed success. Failure has come to everybody's life. All the dignitaries, all the big guys, they have faced failures. Don't get deprived, it is a part of the life. So now all of you, I wish best of success in your life. Last thing I would like to tell you, God has given you a beautiful machine. First, take care of your machine. Don't put garbage. Maintain your health, that will support you throughout your life, and the success is with you. Irrespective of any support, any finance or anything, you will be successful in your life. So thank you very much, friends, for giving me some time.